Got a little bit of color in my mortar. Okay, y'all, I'll just bring you back when you can see more. Okay, day two. I stopped yesterday because it was so dark. Things were getting wonky, still are wonky, but at least today I've got a little bit more daylight. It's bright and sunny outside, and you can still see how dark it is back here. And so I'll just pick up today and see where I left off yesterday. Even with a little light there, it was just so dark yesterday, and I was having trouble seeing my bubble on my level and all that other good stuff, so I just quit yesterday. So this stuff is setting up pretty good. I brushed it a little bit, but then I had, while I was brushing it, one of my Rick's dirt fell off. That's okay. Well, we'll go about that again. Okay, we are done with this thing. As you can see, it's still kind of, the mortar hadn't cured, but I just put this final capstone on. And it is a mess here. I'm so glad to get this done. I used pavers to cap it, except for right here. Well, that's paver too, actually. But this is what the type of paver I was going to do the whole thing in. But then I decided, you know what? I've got all these bricks locally in my ditch, in my creek. You know, this back part didn't really turn out like I'd wanted. I'm still cool with it. And I still may put some touch, you know, final tunes on it, you know, something a little. But anyway, capped it off with pavers. And the only thing, that one is the only thing that didn't come from this property. Even the water that I used to mix the mortar came from this property. These here, this rock here, that rock, that little vertical rock, and that rock, and that rock. No, not that rock, but the ovens. I don't know what they are. They are so smooth. They're almost like a machine smooth rock. And there was another thing I found on my property that way, and I don't know what I did with it. But they're just so smooth. That both of them almost, you know, pie shaped. I have don't have a clue what they are, but you know, other than rocks. But I wanted to include those. Little round thing right there, it's 30-30 case. That right there is a 30-30 case. This one was first buck I killed here. This is the one I used to kill the one this year. But anyway, those rocks are just so cool. They are just so smooth, as opposed to regular limestone or sandstone rock like that one. That one's kind of arrowhead shaped, so I just want something different. The red is I don't know. When I told one of the older ladies that I work for that what I was doing, she said, and I was putting things in this. Well, I'll just tell you the story. When I was a kid, my grandpa and grandma had this old rock house, and you know, the big thick huge, they call them flagstone today, but they're huge rocks, sandstone rocks in this area, and they had huge mortar joints. Well, somebody, when they built it, put marbles in those joints every so often, every other place, something like that. Well, me being, I don't know, I was probably four, something like that. Hey, marbles, all I have to do is dig these marbles out. And my grandpa caught me with a screwdriver and a hammer trying to get one of them out. And man, he lit my butt on fire. And so anyway, but I always thought that was so cool how they just put stuff in the mortar. And so when I did this, that's what I just put little things that, you know, there. Unfortunately, there's some chert rocks I found down in a creek and this embedded in this mortar, and apparently I brushed over them or something, and I'm gonna have to clean all that up. I still got a lot of cleaning to do once this cures. I've wire brushed it already a couple times and took old rag to it. I just gotta clean this up. This has made a mess out of my cabin, but I'm done now. So, but anyway, that's why I put some of these things embedded. Like I said, all these brick, all the rock, except for the pavers on top and these pavers here, came from either from the ditches or the creek behind the house here. So, now, except for that red rock, and that, as I was saying, this lady I worked for, she said, hey, I got some things you may want to put in there. I said, okay. And this, I don't think is a rock. I think it's some kind of high density. It's real dense. It's real heavy, but it looks like plastic to me. But, and it almost has to be. She said this came from Tucson, Arizona. I've never seen a rock like that. If it is, it's faceted, really sharp facets. This is, she gave me, is a crystal. She said came from a cave in Wyoming. So I thought that was cool. I didn't know where I was going to put this. I wasn't going to put it back here. By the way, this brick is here to hold this flagstone level until the mortar dries. Yeah, I got my back a little wonky. I'm not happy about it, but I'll live. So anyway, this is one of the crystals here. I was getting finished. And I said, man, I looked for a piece of brick that fit that. I looked and looked, couldn't. And I thought, now I thought, hey, I got that crystal. I bet that'll go right in there. And sure enough, fit right in there. It was almost like it was made for that spot. So,